Hello, I am Dr. Chunghyun Park from Sosan Duty Dental Office. I'm going to talk about full mouth rehabilitation with immediate loading. Temporary teeth are the most tricky part when it comes to the full mouth implant restoration. Immediate loading can give the maximum satisfaction to the patients with masticatory and aesthetic results. With immediate loading, temporary restoration fracture or loss can pose a grave danger. Temporary teeth are very important. I'll talk about what need to be considered for immediate loading with severe cases. Let me give you know-how how to prevent temporary restoration fracture. In the previous case, the restoration was reinforced with wire, but fracture occurred because the resin itself was too thin. Only a few teeth are remaining in this case. 5 implants are placed in the mandible, and then abutments are connected, direct impression and bite registration were performed. In a lab, temporary restoration was made, but it was too thin, so we thickened it with resin, and it was immediately loaded. It looks like the temporary restoration from the lab may break. Of course, it's better aesthetically, but if you look at the bottom photo, the thick one looks safer. Even the thick one should have sufficient interdental spaces so that a patient can do the maintenance. What do you think about this case? It's a temporary restoration, but it is not removed with ejector or calipers, but it is being cut with a burr. Let me explain why it is so. It is because final cement is used to attach the temporary restoration. The success rate of immediate loading would go up when temporary restoration is attached very firmly, because it may fail with just the cement washout. It can be risky, so I use final cement mainly for attaching temporary restorations. It is important. With the abutments connected, the final impression was acquired. So the abutments used for the temporary are also adopted for the final prosthesis. Using resin, posterior stub was formed, an anterior silicone bite was taken. After restoration in the mandible, the patient wanted the full mouth implant restoration in the maxilla. I'll show you later. Impression taking for temporary restoration. In the maxilla, implants were placed. In the central incisor area with a sufficient bone width, cantilever is planned for the lateral. Can you see the yellow arrow? Stock abutments were connected and silicone impression taking was performed. Look at it carefully. Silicone impression material remains in the incision line. So you need to carefully check something like this after impression is taken by your staff. Otherwise, a temporary can be delivered on a patient over this. The small mistake like this can make a big difference in the result. Silicone material should not be remaining in the incision line. We need to observe that. This is based on my experience. So for immediate loading, I try not to use silicone. For temporary impression taking, I use scanning or alginate. For temporary teeth, the cross-arch splinting is good, but if it is made in one piece like this, implant path should be similar. In the anterior and posterior regions, the path may be different, so it is very difficult to make a one-piece restoration. I'd like to make a two-piece temporary that is cemented and fixed with resin. The path in the posterior was different from anterior, but splinting effect was achieved. What is important is a lab should be told not to high polish the connection part. before it is sent to the treatment room. If polishing is done with a pumice or rouge, resin's bonding strength can be decreased. The abutments used for the temporary were adopted. Abutment level impression was taken for the final prosthesis. Next, bite registration, CR record. This is a complete maxillary edentulous patient. Complete denture is planned for the maxilla, and fixed type implant restoration is planned for the mandible. Let's briefly go over what we learned in the previous lecture. I determined vertical dimension using physiologic rest position. Abutment level impression was taken using wax rim. CR was acquired. To fabricate for both maxilla and mandible, for maxilla, anterior only arrangement is made. For mandible, three-piece temporary restoration is made due to the different paths of placement in the anterior and posterior. I'll show you again how to connect and fix the three pieces. Intraorally, the temporary was cemented with the final cement first, and the temporary restoration was connected and fixed with resin. This way, cross-splinting was achieved, even the placement paths were different, and CR was acquired again. You can arrange all the way up to posterior in one try, but I prefer to take CR again for the posterior region as it can reduce the adjustment time. After using the temporary for 2 to 3 months, the next step is the final prosthesis. Moving on to the final prosthesis after temporary, that is a simple step. A panorama x-ray after completing final prosthesis. Next, abutment selection. A few teeth remained in the upper anterior. One implant remained. The remaining implants were removed. Implants were placed for immediate loading. Stuck abutments were connected. As the placement path in the posterior and anterior were different, angled abutments were used in the anterior. In the treatment room, roughly a rim was fabricated to take CR relation. As I explained before, a three-piece temporary restoration was fabricated, cemented, and connected with resin. As the patient had no concern for smile line, so equi-margin final prosthesis was determined rather than subgingival margin for the anterior. I believe this is important. I believe stock abutments are not good enough for the anterior region. So like this, custom abutments were fabricated again. When implant placement paths are very different like this, and if you use transfer impression coping for impression taking, it's very difficult to remove the impression material. So I prefer to use regular body only rather than the heavy body. Now we can find a problem. I did the intraoral abutment adjustment and removed some gold coating. The metal abutment in the zirconia prosthesis is showing. To reduce such problem in the anterior maxilla, we need to use gold-coated abutments, or inside of zirconia should be treated to be opaque. Next, the final impression taking. At number 24 and 25, the abutments used for temporary were adopted for the final prosthesis. At number 26, custom abutment was fabricated. What we need to consider is that when we use the abutment level impression taking, subgingival margins appear in several places. How can we resolve the problem? In my case, when stuck abutments are not prepared or adjusted, the same size stuck abutments would be scanned in advance with a model scanner when we can assume all stuck abutment sizes are the same. And when we bring in and merge the image file, we can easily obtain subgingival margin. That means impression taking can be taken up to the visible part. There was a subgingival margin. The margin was not properly registered when impression was taken, but through merging, proper final prosthesis was fabricated. For mandible implant level, impression was taken in one try and the final prosthesis was completed. It doesn't matter if you use abutment level or implant level impression taking. I tried to use the stock abutments used during the immediate loading before. Then more abutment level impression would be taken. The subgingival margin problem can be overcome with merging. It is regrettable that abutment metal color is showing in the upper anterior. Final prosthesis was completed. Final panorama image. These days, the hot topic is OneGuide, immediate loading using OneGuide. For merging, resin markers are attached. Based on that, CT images were taken. Regarding the fabrication process, master course will provide the details. The guide is fixed in the mouth. Implants were placed and stock abutments were connected. CT image after placement. Here, let me explain. At number 47, leaving the safe space of 1.5 millimeters from the guide, 8.5 millimeter implant was placed, but the distal part of the implant was too close to the nerve, so it was replaced by 7 millimeter implant. I want to make sure is that even though you use a guide and the distance to the inferior alveolar nerve is very short, please do not blindly trust the guide. Before you place the implant in full depth, you need to check by taking a panorama x-ray or using your routine. Panorama x-ray after placement. I'm showing this repeatedly. The wax is softened with hot water and the patient is biting on it. Physiologic rest position and the height differences are compared. Using aloe wax, the rim height is increased to be in the 2 to 4 millimeter range from the physiologic rest position. During the temporary, the CR was taken 1 to 1.5 millimeter lower than the physiologic rest position considering continuous occlusal adjustments. That is, it was acquired with a little bit higher VD. CR acquisition is completed. Model scanning after taking alginate impression. Inner lap after mounting on the semi-adjustable articulator, the bite relationship was scanned with a model scanner. A temporary bridge was designed. As one guide was used, the placement path were appropriate, so one piece temporary was fabricated. Now, final prosthesis. Final panorama x-ray. Summary. Like this, for full mouth rehabilitation, treatment planning and design is very important. If you use one guide, the implant placement positions will be close to the plan, bringing you one step closer to the perfect prosthesis. In the weak bone of maxilla, implants are submerged after placement. A temporary is used, and after osseointegration, final prosthesis can be made. That's a good option. Don't be obsessed with the immediate loading for full mouth rehabilitation. Even with delayed loading, temporary is required. A temporary was used for at least 1 month for adjustment, followed by digital scanning to complete the posterior region. After completing the posterior region, rubber impression is taken for the anterior. Subgingival margins are showing here and there. Before custom abutment was connected, the abutment was scanned through merging. Subgingival margin images were acquired. It may not be easy to understand what I'm saying. That will be explained in the master course. In this lecture, we talked about immediate loading for full mouth fixed implant restorations, immediate loading on the bilaterally connected restoration is a highly successful and predictable procedure. I believe you will get very good outcome if you try the immediate loading based on what you learned today. I'll come back with next lecture. Thank you.